Good evening, everyone. Welcome to NEET PG Life Daily. Myself, Dr. Apurva Mittal, and today we'll be discussing about lung volume and capacities. What are lung volume and capacities, how they are measured, and how can we diagnose different diseases, whether obstructive or restrictive lung diseases, through these lung volume and capacities values. So welcome to Unacademy. Unacademy is one of the leading platform for online courses, and by getting Unacademy Plus subscription, you will be able to avail all the live classes for the 19 subjects which are required for NEET PG examination. Also interact with the top educators. We'll be having test series and analysis in which you can evaluate the progress, and also live doubt clearing sessions in which you can clear the doubt pertaining to the subjects required for the NEET PG. And this Unacademy subscription, you can get it either for 12 months or 24 months. And if you apply my code, that is Apurva Live, APURVA Live, you can get 10% discount on the same. So friends, let's start our today's topic, that is lung volume and capacities. It is a very important topic for the NEET examination. Many questions are asked as image based questions. They can just give you the graph and ask you what it is or how is it measured, and also the diagnosis of the disease. So from NEET PG point of view also, it is very important. From the anesthesiologist point of view, through this, you know, in the pre-anesthetic checkups, we frequently ask for these volumes and capacities so that we can know what problems we can encounter during our procedure. Okay, now the lung volume and capacities, they are of two types, that is the static lung volume and capacity or the dynamic. Static, as the name suggests, in static lung volume and capacities, the time is not considered. In this, the time is not considered, whereas in the dynamic lung volume and capacities, the time factor is taken into account. Okay, so lung volume and capacities, they can be static or dynamic. What are static? In this, the time is not considered, whereas in dynamic, the time factor is taken into account. Now, the static lung volume capacities, okay, they are recorded through this machine, and this is known as spirometer. If this is important, it has been asked as an image-based question. Okay, so this is what is known as a spirometer, and the recording, the graph which we get, is known as a spirogram. Okay, so this is the machine which is used to measure the static lung volume and capacities. Dr. Pragya, good evening. Welcome to the class. Okay, so what are the static lung volume and capacities? Okay, so first of all, when we are normally inspiring and expiring, inspire kare increase hoga, theek hai, expire kare decrease hoga. Ye jo normal inspiration or expiration ho rahi hai, that is known as the tidal volume. Theek hai, the normal, without any force, the normal inspiration and expiration is known as the tidal volume. Okay, now what is, okay, so that is the tidal volume. Okay, now what is the inspiratory reserve volume? Inspiratory reserve matlab ye reserve hai, hai na? So agar ekdam se normal inspiration lete hue hum logon ne usse zyada forceful liya, theek hai, so inspiratory reserve volume, it is the extra volume of air. Okay, it is the reserve is always extra. So it is the extra volume of air that can be inhaled by maximum inspiratory effort over and beyond the normal tidal volume. So ye to normal tidal volume hai, theek hai, ye to normal tidal volume hai. Iske upar agar hum log एक्स्ट्रा वॉल्यूम इंस्पायर कर रहे हैं विद द मैक्सिमम इंस्पिरेटरी एफर्ट, दैट इज नोन एज द इंस्पिरेटरी रिजर्व वॉल्यूम. ओके, नाउ व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय द एक्सपिरेटरी रिजर्व वॉल्यूम? एक्सपिरेटरी रिजर्व वॉल्यूम ये हो गई, ठीक है. दिस इज द एक्सपिरेटरी रिजर्व वॉल्यूम, मतलब इट इज वॉट, इट इज द एक्स्ट्रा वॉल्यूम ऑफ एयर दैट कैन बी एक्सहेल्ड बाय मैक्सिमल फोर्सफुल एक्सपिरेशन ओवर एंड बियॉन्ड द नॉर्मल टाइडल वॉल्यूम. रिमेंबर, इंस्पिरेटरी रिजर्व एंड एक्सपिरेटरी रिजर्व वॉल्यूम, दीज आर ओवर एंड बियॉन्ड द नॉर्मल टाइडल वॉल्यूम. इंस्पिरेटरी में ओवर एंड बियॉन्ड नॉर्मल टाइडल वॉल्यूम हम कितना और इंस्पायर कर सकते हैं, और एक्सपिरेटरी रिजर्व वॉल्यूम में ओवर एंड बियॉन्ड टाइडल वॉल्यूम हाउ मच कैन बी एक्सपायर. ओके, सो टाइडल वॉल्यूम नॉर्मल वैल्यू इज 500 to 750 ml, ठीक है. इंस्पिरेटरी रिजर्व इज अराउंड 3000 ml, जबकि एक्सपिरेटरी रिजर्व इज अराउंड 1200 ml. ओके, सो दीज आर थ्री वॉल्यूम्स. नाउ व्हाट इज, एक और वॉल्यूम होती है, व्हाट इज रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम, ठीक है. तो रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम इज दिस, दिस इज रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम, मतलब द वॉल्यूम ऑफ एयर विच इज रिमेनिंग इन द लंग आफ्टर, कितना, आफ्टर फोर्सफुल एक्सपिरेशन, ठीक है. रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम कितना है, इट इज द वॉल्यूम ऑफ एयर लेफ्ट इन द लंग्स आफ्टर फोर्सफुल, रिमेंबर दिस वर्ड, इट इज फोर्सफुल एक्सपिरेशन, ठीक है, दैट इज इक्वल टू 1300 ml. ओके, अगर इंक्रीज इन द रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम है, इफ देर इज इंक्रीज इन द रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम दैन द नॉर्मल वैल्यू, दैट मीन्स देर इज एयर ट्रैपिंग, दैट मीन्स देर इज एयर ट्रैपिंग. ओके, एंड रेशियो ऑफ रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम टू द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी, आई टेल यू वॉट इज टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी, इट इज इंक्रीज इन केस ऑफ द ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव डिसीजेस लाइक एम्फाइसीमा एंड ब्रोंकियल अस्थमा, ठीक है. तो रिवाइजिंग वन मोर, और एक और लास्ट वॉल्यूम इज द क्लोजिंग वॉल्यूम. क्लोजिंग वॉल्यूम याद रखना, क्लोजिंग वॉल्यूम, इट इज द वॉल्यूम ऑफ एयर एट विच द लोअर मोस्ट एल्वियोलाई, ठीक है, द लोअर मोस्ट एल्वियोलाई बिगिंस टू क्लोज ड्यूरिंग एक्सपिरेशन. एक्सपिरेशन के बाद द वॉल्यूम एट विच द लोअर मोस्ट एल्वियोलाई बिगिन टू क्लोज इज नोन एज the closing volume. Dr. Dharmendra, welcome to the class. We are discussing about the lung volume and capacities. Please let me know if there are any doubts. Till now, I have just discussed about the what are the different static lung volume. These are the lung volumes in which the time is not considered. And coming to the tidal volume, take a tidal volume, it is inspired air or expired with each breath. What is inspiratory reserve? It is the reserve. So, matlab extra volume of air which we can inspire above and beyond the tidal volume. Expiratory reserve volume, it is the extra volume of air that can be exhaled by maximum forceful expiration over and beyond the normal tidal volume. Okay? And residual volume, it is the volume of air which is in the lung after forceful expiration. Now, कैपेसिटीज, कैपेसिटीज डिफरेंट के जो अपने वॉल्यूम्स पढ़े थे, टाइडल वॉल्यूम, आईआरवी, ईआरवी एंड ऑल्सो द रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम, उनके एडिशन से देयर आर डिफरेंट कैपेसिटीज विच आर फॉर्म. सो व्हाट इज इंस्पिरेटरी कैपेसिटी? इट इज द मैक्सिमम वॉल्यूम ऑफ एयर दैट कैन बी इंस्पायर्ड आफ्टर नॉर्मल टाइडल एक्सपिरेशन, ठीक है. तो आफ्टर ये क्या हो गया, नॉर्मल टाइडल एक्सपिरेशन, तो अमाउंट ऑफ एयर विच कैन बी इंस्पायर्ड आफ्टर दिस, तो वो क्या हो गया, दैट इज नोन एज द इंस्पिरेटरी कैपेसिटी. सो दिस इज दिस, ठीक है, आफ्टर ये हम लोगों ने नॉर्मल एक्सपिरेशन लिया, आफ्टर दैट हाउ मच कैन बी इंस्पायर, दैट इज नोन एज द इंस्पिरेटरी कैपेसिटी. So, inspiratory capacity is equal to the tidal volume plus the inspiratory reserve volume. ठीक है, ऐसे ही what is functional residual capacity? Functional residual capacity is, see, residual. So, it will be remaining in the lung. So, amount of air which is remaining in the lung आफ्टर नॉर्मल टाइडल एक्सपिरेशन, ठीक है, आफ्टर नॉर्मल टाइडल एक्सपिरेशन, ठीक है, द अमाउंट ऑफ एयर विच इज रिमेनिंग इन द लंग, तो वो कितना हो गए, ए आर वी प्लस आर वी, ठीक है, ए आर वी प्लस आर वी, दैट इज द फंक्शनल रेसिडुअल कैपेसिटी. इज इट क्लियर? इज इट क्लियर डॉक्टर प्रज्ञा, डॉक्टर धर्मेंद्र, इज इट क्लियर? सो दैट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ एयर विच इज रिमेनिंग इन द लंग आफ्टर नॉर्मल एक्सपिरेशन. आफ्टर नॉर्मल एक्सपिरेशन, अगर फोर्सफुल एक्सपिरेशन होता तो दैट इज रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम. आफ्टर नॉर्मल एक्सपिरेशन, दैट इज द फंक्शनल रेसिडुअल कैपेसिटी. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट इज वाइटल कैपेसिटी? What is vital capacity? It is the maximum amount of air that can be exhaled after a maximum inspiration. ठीक है, तो after taking maximum inspiration, उसके बाद how much I can exhale? ठीक है, तो क्या हो गया, IRV plus tidal volume plus ERV. That is my vital capacity. This is the vital capacity. ठीक है, after forceful inspiration, how much I can expire? So I can expire IRV plus tidal plus ERV. ठीक है, that is what is known as vital capacity. Or total lung capacity, all the parameters, that is IRV plus TV plus ERV plus RV. ठीक है, that is known as the total lung capacity. So is it clear? Inspiratory capacity is nothing plus it is TV plus IRV. Okay, what is the functional residual capacity? Functional residual capacity is ERV plus residual volume. The vital capacity, how much air I can expire after forceful inspiration. So that will be IRV plus TV plus ERV. Okay, and total lung capacity is vital capacity plus residual volume. Is it clear? So this is about the static lung volume and capacities. Now closing volume, at which the during expiration the lowermost alveoli were getting closed. Okay, so closing capacity is the volume of air that remains in the lung when lowermost alveoli are closed. So that is what is known as the closing capacity. Now, the next question which is asked is, there are certain lung volumes and capacities which cannot be measured by spirometry. Okay, the lung volume and capacities which cannot be measured by spirometry. So spirometry se basically we are not able to measure the residual volume. So therefore residual volume is there. What is FRC? FRC is ERV plus RV, and therefore residual volume is not measured through spirometry. I cannot measure the FRC also. This is also ERV plus RV plus IRV plus TV, and here as residual volume is there, therefore total lung capacity can also not be measured. So the lung volume and capacity that cannot be measured by spirometry is basically it is the residual volume. So the features which have residual volume in it cannot be measured by a lung spirometry. Okay, now these are measured by the functional residual capacity. Basically it can be measured with the help of the helium dilution method, okay, nitrogen washout method, or body plethysmography. This is the question which is asked. This can be measured with the help of the helium dilution, nitrogen washout method, and body plethysmography. Okay, now those were the static lung capacities which were not time dependent. Now there are the dynamic lung volume and capacities, and these dynamic lung volume and capacities are basically they are dependent on the time. So what are those? These are the forced vital capacity. Okay, forced vital capacity, FEV1. Okay, it is the forced vital capacity in forced expiratory volume in first second. ठीक है, फर्स्ट एक्सपिरेटरी वॉल्यूम इन फर्स्ट सेकेंड. देन वॉट इज पीक एक्सपिरेटरी फ्लो रेट एंड मैक्सिमम मिड एक्सपिरेटरी फ्लो रेट. सो दीज आर द वंस विच आर द डायनेमिक लंग वॉल्यूम एंड कैपेसिटीज, एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नाउ सी, नॉर्मल नॉर्मल वाइटल कैपेसिटी, ठीक है, नॉर्मल वाइटल कैपेसिटी कितनी होती है? नॉर्मल वाइटल कैपेसिटी इज इक्वल टू द आईआरवी, है ना, आईआरवी प्लस टाइडल वॉल्यूम प्लस ईआरवी. नॉर्मल वाइटल कैपेसिटी आईआरवी प्लस टाइडल वॉल्यूम प्लस ईआरवी, ठीक है. और ये जो टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी होती है वो नॉर्मल कितनी होती है? अराउंड 6 लीटर. This vital capacity is also the forced vital capacity. Again, the forced vital capacity, it is telling us about the about the status of our inspiratory muscles basically. Okay, so the vital capacity, that is also known as the forced vital capacity, which is known as the inspiratory reserve volume, which is the sum of inspiratory reserve volume plus tidal volume plus the expiratory reserve volume. Okay, now this is the normal alveoli. So there will be inflation, there will be inspiration and expiration, and during inspiration there will be inflation of the alveoli. Okay, there will be inflation of the alveoli. Now इसमें दिस ग्राफ, ये जो ग्राफ है, दिस इज नोन एज द फ्लो वॉल्यूम लूप. इट इज अ लूप, इट इज अ लूप बिटवीन द फ्लो ऑफ द गैशियस मिक्सचर एंड द वॉल्यूम, ठीक है. तो नाउ व्हाट इज दिस पॉइंट, व्हाट इज दिस पॉइंट, इट इज द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी. ठीक है, यहाँ पे जो वॉल्यूम लिया है, ये जो 6 लीटर्स है, यहाँ पे है टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी. ठीक है, ये जो 6 लीटर्स है, दिस इज द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी, एंड दिस इज व्हाट द रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम. ठीक है, तो व्हेन दिस इज द इंस्पिरेटरी फेज, दिस इज द इंस्पिरेटरी फेज एंड दिस इज द एक्सपिरेटरी फेज. ठीक है, दिस इज द एक्सपिरेटरी फेज. तो क्या होगा जब पेशेंट, ओके, व्हेन द पेशेंट इज क्या बोलते हैं, इंस्पायरिंग. ठीक है, व्हेन द पेशेंट इज इंस्पायरिंग, दिस विल बी द लूप, एंड व्हेन द पेशेंट एक्सपायर्स, दिस इज द लूप. ओके, नाउ व्हाट इज टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी? इट इज द टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ एयर व्हिच कैन बी अकोमोडेटेड. इट इज अराउंड 6 लीटर्स पर मिनट. ठीक है, ओके, नाउ when the patient is inspiring, he won't be inspiring, ye residual volume nahi lega. theek hai, residual volume nahi lega, that is FVC. to yahan pe isne inspire kiya, fir isne expire kiya. the volume or the loop which is formed by this is the inspiration and this is the expiratory loop. Okay, and this is the residual volume, this is the residual volume. So this is the total lung capacity, this is the residual volume. And what is total lung capacity minus the residual volume? That is known as the forced vital capacity, which is also known as the vital capacity. Okay, so this is IRV, okay, plus the tidal volume plus the expiratory reserve volume, that is FVC, and minus the residual volume, that is the forced vital capacity. Now when I am plotting this graph, is it clear, Dr. Pragya, Dr. Dharmendra, is it clear? Isme kya hai, it is the flow volume loop. Theek hai, it is a flow volume loop. Idhar jo x axis pe hai, that is the volume, and idhar jo y axis pe hai, that is flow. Theek hai, that is flow. So this नीचे वाला इज द इंस्पिरेटरी फ्लो एंड दिस इज द एक्सपिरेटरी फ्लो. ठीक है, द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी, द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी इज 6 लीटर्स, इज 6 लीटर्स. ठीक है, नाउ व्हेन द पेशेंट इज एक्सपायरिंग, व्हेन द पेशेंट इज एक्सपायरिंग, ठीक है, देयर विल बी द रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम व्हिच विल बी लेफ्ट. which will be left, and then the patient will inspire from there. So what is forced vital capacity? That is TLC minus RV. When I am plotting this in the graph, that is volume against the time, what I get is, what is the normal the normal FVC is around 5. So jab pehle wo during the first time of expiration it is steep, and then it will be a plateau phase. Okay, then it will be a plateau phase. So this whole in 10 seconds, that is the forced vital capacity, and when it is extrapolated against 1 second, okay, the amount of air which is expired in 1 second forcefully, that is FEV1. Okay, and as we are seeing, this FEV1 upon the FVC, okay, FEV1 upon the FVC, normally the ratio is more than 80%. Okay, so this is the normal graph. Now, what is peak? Peak expiratory volume. Peak expiratory volume is maximum flow of air during forceful expiration. Ye jo forceful expiration pe maximum volume of air that can be expired. So this is what is known as PEEF, and it maximum expiratory of expiration, and this is effort dependent. ठीक है. नॉर्मल ये जो होता है दैट इज 6.5 टू 10 लीटर्स पर सेकेंड. ठीक है, तो ये हो गया. नाउ व्हाट इज मैक्सिमम मिड एक्सपिरेटरी फ्लो रेट? मैक्सिमम मिड एक्सपिरेटरी, ये जो एक्सपिरेटरी ग्राफ है, ये जो डाउन स्लोप है, दैट इज द एवरेज फ्लो ड्यूरिंग द मिड हाफ ऑफ द एफवीसी. एफवीसी के मिड हाफ पे, दैट इज फ्रॉम 25 275, उसके मिड हाफ पे व्हाट इज द एवरेज फ्लो ऑफ एयर, एंड दिस अगर इसमें इस वाले स्लोप में कुछ डिफरेंस आएगा, दैट द सेंसिटिव मार्कर फॉर अर्ली एयरवे ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. दैट इज अ सेंसिटिव मार्कर फॉर अर्ली एयरवे ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. ठीक है, तो ये अपना एक तो नॉर्मल ग्राफ है. ठीक है, दिस इज द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी विच इज 6 लीटर्स. दिस इज द इंस्पिरेटरी फेज व्हेन द पेशेंट विल फोर्सफुली एक्सपायर. द मैक्सिमम वॉल्यूम ऑफ एयर दैट ही कैन एक्सपायर, दैट इज द पीक एक्सपिरेटरी फ्लो रेट, एंड देन देर विल बी अ डाउन स्लोप इन द एक्सपिरेटरी फेज. ठीक है, देन देर विल बी अ डाउन स्लोप इन द एक्सपिरेटरी फेज. ओके, एंड द अमाउंट ऑफ एयर विच विल बी लेफ्ट, ओके, दैट इज द रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम. So TLC minus residual volume will give us the functional residual capacity. Now, what happens in case of the obstructive disease? See, this is a normal spirogram. Okay, in the obstructive disease, because there is obstruction in the airway, what happens? The inspiratory reserve volume, the amount of air the patient can inspire over and above the tidal volume, that decreases. The inspiratory reserve volume, it decreases. The tidal volume, it almost remains the same. Okay. So, and the expiratory, what happens in obstruction? The air cannot be expired completely. So there is hyperinflation of the lung. So what will happen? The residual volume and the expiratory reserve volume will increase. So if I'll see, what is my vital, forced vital capacity? Forced vital capacity kitna hai? IRV plus TV plus ERV. है ना, दैट इज ऑलमोस्ट सेम, बट बिकॉज ऑफ द हाइपर इन्फ्लेशन ऑफ द लंग, द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी एंड द फोर्स्ड रेसिडुअल कैपेसिटी, ये द फंक्शनल रेसिडुअल कैपेसिटी एंड द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी, दे इंक्रीज इन केस ऑफ द ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव लंग डिसीज. The obstructive lung disease mein, because there is airway obstruction, the IRV, it decreases, the TV, the tidal volume, it remains same, बिकॉज ऑफ द हाइपर इन्फ्लेशन ऑफ द लंग, ठीक है, जैसे एम्फाइसीमा में होता है, एम्फाइसीमा में क्या होता है, एल्वियोलर के अंदर एयर ट्रैपिंग हो जाती है, उसकी वजह से द रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम एंड द एक्सपिरेटरी रिजर्व वॉल्यूम इट इंक्रीजेस. सो द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी एंड द फंक्शनल रेसिडुअल कैपेसिटी दोज इंक्रीज, बट द फोर्स्ड वाइटल कैपेसिटी ऑलमोस्ट रिमेन्स सेम. सो हाउ विल बी इन द फ्लो वॉल्यूम लूप, ठीक है, तो फ्लो वॉल्यूम लूप कैसा होगा. सी, ये जो ब्लैक से है दैट इज द नॉर्मल फ्लो वॉल्यूम लूप. तो नॉर्मल टीएलसी 6 लीटर है, ठीक है, और रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम कितना होता है नॉर्मली, 1300 तक, ठीक है. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस इन केस ऑफ द ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव लंग डिजीज टू द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी. द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी वो भी इंक्रीज हो रही है. द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी इज इंक्रीजिंग, है ना, ये 0 to 6, ये ग्राफ कहाँ पे, लेफ्ट साइड पे हो गया. सो द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी इट इज इंक्रीजिंग, ठीक है, द टोटल लंग कैपेसिटी इज इंक्रीजिंग. माई रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम इट इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीजिंग, द रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम इज इंक्रीजिंग, ये जो येलो से है. ओके, सो दीज टू पैरामीटर्स हैव इंक्रीज्ड, बट द फोर्सफुल एक्सपिरेशन, ठीक है, द PEF वैल्यू, द पीक एक्सपिरेटरी फ्लो, इट डिक्रीजेस, द पीक एक्सपिरेटरी फ्लो रेट इट डिक्रीजेस, and also because of the early airway obstruction, यहाँ पे क्या है, there is kinking, यहाँ पे scalloped shape या फिर dog feet shape like kink होगा, that is seen in cases of the obstructive airway disease because there is obstruction to the airflow, okay, and the inspiratory parameter is same. So इन दिस वॉट हैपन्स, इसमें क्या क्या हुआ, ऑब्जेक्टिव में टी एल सी इंक्रीज हुआ, from 6 liters इट माइट हैव इंक्रीज टू 8 liters, वाई, बिकॉज ऑफ द हाइपर इन्फ्लेशन. रेसिडुअल वॉल्यूम भी इंक्रीज हुआ, ठीक है, पीक एक्सपिरेटरी फ्लो रेट भी डिक्रीज हुआ, ठीक है, मिड एक्सपिरेटरी फ्लो रेट That is also it decreasing, और उस वाले फेज में there is galloping which is seen. Now if I am plotting this on FVC versus time, ठीक है, ये क्या है, volume versus time graph को अगर मैं करूंगी, ठीक है, तो normal FVC कितना होता है, around 5 liters, ये जो black से है that is around 5 liters, ठीक है, और FEV1 normally around 4 liters, तो normally it is more than 80%. What happens in objective, the FVC upon time graph, it is like this, ठीक है, ये जो slope होता है वो there will be decrease in the forced expiratory volume in the first second. See, in the first second there is drastic decrease in the FEV1, okay, but the FVC value might be same, and therefore the ratio of FEV1 upon FVC is less than 70%. The ratio of FEV1 upon FVC is less than 70%. This happens in case of the obstructive lung disease. Now what happens in restrictive lung disease? Restrictive lung disease mein there is restriction to both inspiration and during expiration. So isme jitne bhi volumes hai wo sare decrease ho rahe hain except the tidal volume. So the inspiratory reserve volume is decreased, expiratory reserve volume decreases, residual volume decreases, so overall the FVC also decreases and the total lung capacity also decreases. So ye jaise normal graph tha, to isme kya hoga, TLC from 6 it is decreasing to around 5 or 4, theek hai, the residual volume it is also decreasing, theek hai. So, but इसमें जब मैं FVC the volume versus time graph plot करूंगी, I will see that there is not much decrease in the forced expiratory volume in 1 second, and there is decrease in the FVC. So the drop in FEV1 in comparison to the drop in FVC might be equal or might be even more, and therefore might be equal or might be even less, and therefore the ratio is same or it might also increase. So in obstructive lung disease, the FEV1 upon the FVC ratio is low, as FEV1 drops much more significantly than FVC. But in the restrictive lung disease, the FEV1 upon FVC ratio is normal, as drop in FVC is proportional to the drop in FEV1, and therefore and also sometimes the ratio might increase if the FVC drops more markedly than the FEV1. Is it clear? This is what is flow volume loop. ठीक है, ये flow volume loop बहुत important है. Obstructive lung disease में ये याद रखना कैसे parameters increase हो रहे हैं. And the graph is shifted towards the left side. That is because the total lung capacity, the residual volume, both of them are increased. ठीक है, in restrictive lung disease all the volumes have decreased. ठीक है, and this is FEV1 upon FVC ratio. If it is less than 80, less than 70, that means it is obstructive lung disease. In restrictive lung disease, either it is equal to 80 or might be more than 80%. Okay, so that was the flow volume loops. Now, the other important parameters are the upper airway obstruction. ठीक है, जो ये अपर एयरवे ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन होता है, इट कैन बी वेरिएबल एक्स्ट्रा थोरैसिक, थोरैक्स के बाहर कुछ ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन है, वेरिएबल इंट्रा थोरैक्सिक, थोरैक्स के अंदर से कुछ ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन है, या फिर देयर इज अ फिक्स्ड एयरवे ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. फॉर एग्जांपल, इन वेरिएबल एक्स्ट्रा थोरैसिक ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन, एग्जांपल इज स्लीप एपनिया और द ट्यूमर्स. ठीक है, दीज आर फ्रॉम, it is outside the thorax, and these are variable. Okay, intrathoracic example hai tracheomalacia or the tracheal tumors. Okay, fixed can be because of the foreign body, and this fixed can be either intrathoracic or extrathoracic. Now what happens in variable extrathoracic obstruction? In variable extrathoracic obstruction, okay, because of the obstruction during the inspiration, okay, isme inspiratory flow is hampered. Okay, in this the inspiratory flow is hampered, jabki variable intrathoracic obstruction mein the expiratory loop, the inspiratory loop is fine, but the expiratory loop is hampered. Okay, the expiratory loop is hampered, and this is because bahar se yahan pe pressure ho raha hai. During the expiration, the air is not able to move out, and therefore there is problem in the expiratory loop. So extra thoracic mein kis mein problem hai? Inspiratory mein. Intra thoracic mein kis mein problem hai? Expiration mein. Theek hai? Fixed mein both the inspiratory and the expiratory flow are hampered, and that happens in case of the foreign body. Okay, and this I have just shown you by a simple diagram, because ye direct questions puche jaate hain. Theek hai, extra thoracic variable mein there is problem in the inspiratory loop. In variable intrathoracic, there is problem in the expiratory loop. And in intrathoracic, in fixed obstruction, intrathoracic or extrathoracic, there is problem with both the intrathoracic and extrathoracic loop. Is it clear? So today I have discussed about the various lung volume and capacities. I hope this was clear. Lung volumes, static or dynamic. Dynamic we are seeing through a flow volume loop. okay, and in the obstructive, how it is, in the restrictive, how it is. In obstructive, the FEV1 upon the FVC ratio will be less than 80 and will be less than 70, in fact. And because the drop in FEV1 is much, much greater than the drop in the FVC. And in the restrictive lung disease, it might be equal to 80%, or it might increase also because the drop in FVC is much more than the drop in FEV1. Okay, so that was all for today's class. Thank you and have a nice day. In the special class today, I'll be taking the MCQ sessions of respiratory physiology at 6 p.m. Okay, this is the Telegram app. On this, we have a channel, Neat PG Live. Please download this app and go through this channel. In this channel, I'll be posting about the daily classes, and also please install the Unacademy Learning app and get the Neat PG Plus subscription. You can get it either for 12 months or 24 months. And if you apply my code, that is Apoorva Live, APOORVA Live, you can get 10% discount on the same. On the YouTube, we have Unacademy Neat PG channel. Please click the bell icon, like and share, and use the referral code, that is Apoorva Live, and get 10% discount on the Unacademy subscription. Thank you and have a nice day.